Hello dear students, let us discuss about the transformation of energy in a cell. So the various functions of the living organisms takes place by the absorption of energy. So the absorption of energy takes place through the oxidation of small organic molecules. So that small organic molecules are referred to as the metabolites. So metabolites are nothing but the small organic compounds. When they get oxidized, so the energy is released. So that energy is absorbed by the living organisms for various functions. So let us consider an example. So in this reaction, so the glucose breaks down into carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So during this breakdown of glucose, so the energy which is released is 2870 kilojoules per mole. So this energy is enormous. Okay. So this enormous amount of energy is dangerous to the cells. Okay. So therefore, this reaction takes place in the controlled manner. So when this much amount of energy gets released, so the cells cannot use that much amount of energy, so the cells will go into die. So therefore, so this enormous amount of energy is danger to the cells. So the reaction takes place in the controlled manner, and the energy is released in small increments at certain stages. So the energy is consumed in the form of ATPs, ATP molecules. So these ATP molecules are nothing but the metabolites. So whenever the energy is required, so the energy is released in the form of ATP molecules. So let us continue with the redox potential. So in a redox reaction, so the change in free energy, the change in free energy is proportional to the tendency of the reactants to either lose or gain electrons. Okay, so if the reactant, the reactant which undergoes oxidation is called as the electron donor. So the reactant which undergoes oxidation, which is called as electron donor. So because during the oxidation, so the reactant will lose one or more electrons. So therefore, so the reactant is called as the electron donor. So if the reactant undergoes reduction, so it is called as the electron acceptor. So during reduction, what happens? So the reactant will going to accept one or more electron. So therefore, the reactant which undergoes reduction is called as the electron acceptor. Okay. So in case of the biological processes, so the electron flow in the living cells that lead into a biological oxidant. So for such processes, so the basic principles of electrochemistry can be applicable. Okay. So the basic principles of electrochemistry are applicable to the process of electron flow in the living cells. So the flow of electrons in the living cells. So we know that according to the Nernst equation, the electrode potential E is equal to E naught plus RT divided by NF into ln electron acceptor, the concentration of the electron acceptor divided by the concentration of electron donor according to the Nernst equation. So here the E is the electrode potential. E naught is the standard electrode potential, and n is the number of electrons transferred per molecule, and F is the Faraday. Okay, so we know that the relationship between the standard free energy change for a biological process and the electrode potential, standard electrode potential, is given by the delta G naught is equal to minus NF delta E naught. So this is the relationship between the standard free energy change and the standard electrode potential. So here you can see some of the standard reduction potential of some redox pairs in biologically importance redox pairs. So the reduction of H plus into H2, so the standard reduction potential is given by 0.41 volts. So similar, the reduction of NAD plus to NADH is minus 0.32 volts. So the reduction of FAD to FADH2 is given by 0.22 volt. So similarly, so you can observe some of the substrate couples. So the acetyl coenzyme reduces into pyruvate and coenzyme A. So the reduction potential is given by 0.48 volts. So the keto glutarate reduces into the isocitrate. So during that process, so the redox potential is given by 0.38 volts. So pyruvate, the reduction of pyruvate into lactate, so the standard reduction potential is 0.19 volts.